Excellency Sri Venkaya Naidu Garu, Alternate President of EPSI, Dr. Chaturvedi, Dr. Jayaram, Chancellor of the MS Ramaiya University, Professor Eric, who is going to be our guest of honor today, and Dr. Gupta, Chancellor of Sharda University, all other distinguished invitees, members of the press and media, very good morning to you. It's an important occasion today when we are having a two-day conference, and I would like to thank Dr. Chaturvedi for having organized this conference, and also thank Palaniveru for wonderfully doing this work very well. Education is an important subject for a country, any developing country. And only with education, a nation can come up, individual can come up, and also a society. In fact, our Vice President is an inspiration for the youth of this nation, particularly in the rural areas. Because of education and hard work, he has come up to this level, became a Union Minister, now Vice President of India. And the youth of the country should look at him and how can people can come up with education and hard work. Somehow, education is not a priority in our country. I'm sorry to say so. Because even though the Constitution says that free and compulsory education up to the age of 14, it is true only for those who go to government schools. About half of the youngsters do not go to government schools. In fact, those who receive salary from government do not send their children to government schools. And those who go to private schools, they don't get anything from the state government or the central government. It is time now that we offer free education at all levels. It is possible. There are more than 30 countries in the world where education is offered free up to higher education. We should do something. It means that we'll have to spend more. Both the union government and the state governments have to spend more so that the poor and the middle class will have the benefit of higher education. Out of 14 crore children who are eligible for higher education, only 3.6 crores are getting higher education in 900 universities and 50,000 colleges. In fact, I would like to quote the Prime Minister, and I want the views of Prime Minister to be implemented by the government. It was published in August 2018. I quote from the Honorable Prime Minister, "My dream of New India is that every youth shall have access to higher education as per his choice, learn skills and use it productively in nation building." That is his vision. And again he says, we need an education system that is accessible, affordable and equitable. And that's what we want. It has to be implemented in the country. At present, the last budget, out of 27 lakh crores, only 3% or 3.3% is allotted to education. Same thing happens in the states also. It is time now that we declare that we will offer education at all levels free. If it is not possible, at least for girls, we can begin with girls and later on extend it to others. It is time now that we concentrate on education so that we will also be become an advanced country. The basic of any nation to become an advanced country is education. And I would like this to be given priority both by the union government as well as the governments. I thank our Vice President for having accepted the invitation to be here, and also part of my completing 80 years. I thank the entire organization, all of you, for this important occasion. Thank you very much.